Good evening, Ravers. I've been expecting you. Yes, it's Halloween! Hey! Welcome to Ray Ruttle's Race Night! Welcome to the dining room for the 7:06 and the spooky Sunday steaks. It's Halloween, yes. Very spooky. And smeghetto. Are you having a good Halloween? Maybe you've been trick-or-treating? Or maybe you're hiding with the lights turned off, pretending you ain't in, to avoid having to give any goodies to trick-or-treating? I've been known to do both in my time. Any road, the spooky Sunday steaks will be contested over a distance of 3 feet 11 inches, and the going is firm. And there's 5 runners. Righty-ho, on to the gate draw. And in gate 1 tonight, it's Village Green Preservation Society, ridden by my daughter Maxine. Oh, she's got a goblin mask on, presumably for Halloween. She's going into the spirit of it. Yeah, good on you, girl. You might remember she fell over last time, but still managed to get a win, making plonkers of the tipsters she is. Long may that continue. In gate 2, Rip, ridden by Benny Hill. Oh, he's getting into the spirit of Halloween and all. He's got a hockey mask on. He's been that Jason after the Friday the 13th films, ain't he? Very good, very good. Shame his form's been crap recently, but yeah, good on him for getting into the spirit of Halloween. And in gate 3, it's Don't Eat Yellow Snow, ridden by me. Let's see, what am I wearing? Oh, come on. Is that it? Scissors through head? I could have made a bit more effort than that. I could have got out of them women's underpants, couldn't I? Bloody hell. Oh, get me off, get me off. In gate 4, it's Dallas Green, ridden by Dad. Oh, she's got that scream mask on, ain't she? She's got the scream mask on. She's been decent form, Dallas Green. Popped up back in the top 5. And she's happy with how she's going. She's pleased, she's timing her run well. She's crawling up the table. And she seems to be taking a lot of delight in the fact that DK has been livid in the last few weeks. Forming quite a rival with Emperor. And completing the lineup for tonight, in gate 5, it's Diamond Dallas Page, ridden by DK Lad. Oh, and he's dressed as Captain Chaos tonight. From the Cannonball Run films. He doesn't look happy though, does he? He weren't happy about finishing outside the placings last time out. Yeah, he got in touch. He was blaming everybody. The track, the fences. He wants the three-legged horses turned into glue. And he thinks he's been nobbled by Doddy before the starter's orders. He's blaming everybody but his son. He needs to take a look in the mirror and get some accountability. That's what you need, fella. Control the controllables. Focus on your performance, young man. Anyway, good to see him going into the Halloween spirit with some fancy zest tonight. That's good. On to the odds. And Don't Eat Yellow Snow and Diamond Dallas Page were the outsiders at 5-1. Village Green Preservation Society, she's gone up in the bookies' estimation. She's now at 7-2, along with Rip, but your favourite, who's in a bit of a rich vein of form at the moment. It's Dallas Green, who is at 3-1. Remember, these odds are just for information purposes. Just help you pick a winner. Gamble responsibly. I will not be gambling on fobbing the trick-or-treaters off tonight. I've got a bag of goodies. Don't want to get me house egged and bog-rolled again, like it did one year. Hopefully they'll be satisfied by some fingers of fudge and chomps, but we'll see. Now, last week we saw Blue Movie. Looked like he'd been on the pop again. He were all over the shop last week. But like moonwalking his way down the track. It ended up going off the side of it, I think. But it was Village Green Preservation Society who got another surprise win, despite falling at the final fence. She caught the fence, but toppled over the right side of it and got first place on her back. Dallas Green got the second, and Pumpernickel were third, and Deacon Lad were livid that she finished fourth. What were Blue Movie doing? Are we going to see any other bizarre riding styles from the runners tonight? Let's get to the starting gates and find out. And the runner starters are Dez. And they're off, and away they go. Now, which of the runners is going to take the lead early doors? Diamond Dallas Page looks to be going well on this near side, but he catches the stall, and Rip goes down. It's Don't Eat Yellow Snow, from Village New Preservation Society on the far side as they cross Ruttles Hook. But Dallas Green's in the mix, it's very tight. And Village Green Preservation Society goes down. Oh, that were close. Oh, what's happened there? Oh, no, that's disgraceful. Deaky lad, what have you done there? Oh, you should be ashamed of yourself. What have you done? He has rammed Dallas Green up the backside. That is horrendous. Heinous act. I do not believe it. We have never seen anything that despicable on Ray Ruttle's race night before. Appalling behaviour. Appalling stuff. Oh, my word. Ugh. Let's recap the race. Well, he gave no clue that you were going to behave like that. He got a very good start, did Diamond Dallas Page. You were out in front on this near side with Dallas Green close behind. But then just catches the stool, slips up on it. Not as badly as Rip. You see Rip go down like a sack of spuds there. And it looks to be Don't Eat Yellow Snow and Village Green Preservation Society out in the lead at this point as they get to Ruttles Hook. And Village Green Preservation Society just gets tangled up a little bit by Rip's legs. Don't Eat Yellow Snow's leading by this stage. Dallas Green's in second. Diamond Dallas Page has fallen way behind. I'm not sure why, but he's fallen right off the pace. Must have caught the fence. And you see Village Green Preservation Society go down again. And who wins this at the line? Is it? It's me, isn't it? Oh, it's not. You can see the hoof. Dallas Green's hoof means she takes the win. I'm in second on Don't Eat Yellow Snow. Village Green Preservation Society is third as she slides over yet again. But watch this despicable act from Diamond Dallas Page as he rams Dallas Green right up the arse there. Bloody awful. It's like Eric Cantona's kung fu kick, ain't it? Oh, very lucky that there's no disqualification this season. That should incur a ban. That should get a ban, that, and a points deduction. Disgraceful behaviour. He's a very lucky boy. Very lucky boy. Should be ashamed of his son. Right. Confirmation of the results of the Dining Room 706 and the Spooky Sunday Stakes. First, were your favourite? Dallas Green, 3-1. Justifying the favourite's tag. And hopefully, it ain't sustained any injuries after that incident. Second were me on Don't Eat Yellow Snow, 5-1. And third with Village Green Preservation Society sliding over the finish line yet again as she takes a tumble on the last fence. All five ran, one did not finish. And that were Rip, who came a cropper on the stool right at the start. And once you fall down on one of them early fences, no hope of finishing. And Don't Eat Yellow Snow, Village Green Preservation Society and Dallas Green are battling it out for the win here. But Village Green Preservation Society takes a tumble on the last. And Dallas Green just nabs it by a hoof nail. But the headlines in the papers tomorrow are going to be all about this disgraceful act here from Deaky Lad. Oh, he's ruined Halloween. We were all having a bit of fun, weren't we? And he's ruined it. Disgraceful behaviour. He needs to go away and have a good think about his actions. Dearie me. What's happened to the standings? Well, Buckle of Beer, ridden by John Oliver with no trousers on, still top on 29 points. And All White on the night, second on 23. But Dallas Green moved up to third. She's down 21 points. Is she timing her run to the title superbly? Or has she left it to trickle too late? Steed's in fourth on 20. I get back into the top five on Don't Eat Yellow Snow on 18 points. And then in the bottom half, Scarlet Pumpernel drops down. He's on 17. Rip is on 16 in 7th place. Diamond Dallas Page is in 8th, and he deserves to be after today's disgraceful behaviour. He's on 16 points. Village Green Preservation Society extends the gap between her and Blue Mover. She's on 15. Blue Mover stranded on the botty on 11. So join us in the dining room next week for more fireworks. Sunday, November the 7th at 7 p.m. for the gate drop. And in the meantime, you can go online at rayruttle.com/race night to check out the full standings, the season schedule and sponsorship information should you choose to sponsor a race. And get in touch. Tweet me at Ray Ruttle or pop a comment below or email me via the website. DK and Doddy both got in touch after last week. I wonder what they'll both be thinking after tonight's dramatic scenes. Yeah. And remember to poke the like button, give it a good poking. I don't think Deaky will be poking it tonight, will he? That sounds rude, that, doesn't it? Forget that. share the excitement to race night with your mates, and subscribe to my channel if you ain't already, and I will see you lot next week. Okie do.
Well, that was disgraceful, weren't it, look? Absolutely disgraceful. No, he would not be getting a finger of fudge if he came round to critique tonight, no. How many we got left, anyway? What about the champs? Are any of them left? Yeah, bloody hell.